Well, a Victoria obstetrician is withdrawing his services because he is worried about changes coming to Victoria General Hospital. Dr. John Cooper believes that maternity patients and their unborn children will be at risk. Cooper will continue his gynecology practice, but says a plan to reduce obstetrical anesthesia services won't just be a risk to lives, it will be an issue of legal liability as well. VIHA says its cuts are minor and are misunderstood. ANN's reporter Mary Beth Burton joins us now with the story. Mary Beth.
Hudson changes to obstetrical anesthetic services were supposed to take effect this April 1st. Those changes are now being delayed as the health authority hopes to convince OBGYNs, maternity doctors, and midwives that newborns will not suffer when the cuts come. Emmett Tupper is 4 months old today. He was supposed to be a home birth baby, but during delivery, the midwife noticed his heart rate was dropping rapidly.
So she got that terrible look on her face and said very calmly, okay, let's call the ambulance.
Emmett's mom had an urgent C-section. A caring anesthetist walked her through the procedure.
I was saying, oh, I'm really nauseous. I think I'm going to be sick. She goes, that's because they're stitching up your stomach. It's completely normal. That's fine. And she was describing the whole thing as he was being pulled out. She said, oh, it's a boy. She was great.
Dr. Stephanie Green has delivered 1,500 babies. She's worried about planned funding cuts to obstetrical anesthetic services.
For them to withdraw some service now would be so unfortunate for the women and children of this community. It would put them at risk safety-wise in true emergencies and would make things very difficult for them when they're truly in labor.
The cuts have prompted one resignation.
ANews has obtained this internal memo from John Cooper, an obstetrics and gynecology specialist who is resigning his services in obstetrics effective April 1st. He says this decision is primarily based upon patient safety issues. He believes that as of April 1st, that significant risks to maternity patients and fetuses will occur. He also says that changes being made by VIHA will increase medical legal liability for himself and the hospital.
Well, I think there's a misunderstanding.
VIHA says the full-time obstetric anesthetist will remain at VGH around the clock. It's the backup anesthetist that will be seeing the funding cut.
Second call group is being reduced from 100% to 75%. The reasoning there is that for 8 hours a day, 25% of the time, there are over 10 anesthetists on site in the hospital. So we don't need to fund them to be available because they are already available.
VIHA says that decision will take a total of $57,000 a year divided among VGH's 21 anesthesiologists. But money is not the only issue.
There's not an anesthetist available and they want an epidural for them to have to wait several hours because there's another surgery going on in the hospital. Doesn't seem right.
There is a third call group. It will get paid per consultation instead of an on-call fee. Protests and withdrawal of services are threatened by the specialists on April 1st. That's when VIHA was supposed to implement the changes.
We have extended the changes that we are doing until May 31st.
VIHA plans to meet with anesthesiologists on Wednesday with the hope that the facts about the cuts may prevent planned protests.
And we did attempt to get a hold of Dr. Cooper for comment on this story, but we were told he's out of town today. There are similar cuts coming to Victoria's Royal Jubilee Hospital as well. VIHA says it now spends $325,000 a year on its 24-hour obstetrical anesthesiologist. And it assures us, Hudson, that mothers and their newborns face no risk because of these upcoming cuts.
All right. Mary Beth Burton reporting. Mary Beth, thank you.